information technology governance is all about provides a structure to the IT strategy and business strategy. And you can see the intent of IT governance is related to the corporate governance is a part of that is whereas the IR management is the subsumes of the IT governance. In IT governance, one of the things suddenly emerged and became an important issue is the information technology factor. IT governance plays a major role in business strategies. Nowadays, when come to the history. Is the use of resources. In IT, we use every resources that is available in here, as well as information as well as for technology. The various areas of the IT government's core areas are strategic alignment, value delivery, risk management, resource management, performance. Strategic alignment includes where we can create different ideas which gives the best performance to the organization. Value of the delivery. Here, value is what are the strategies we are using and how much we are expensing on that in implementing the strategy. These are the values of the delivery. Risks. After implementing certain strategies, we'll get some risks. And what are the risks we are getting and how should we reduce them? Resources. What are the resource management is like, what are the resources for the ideas which you have provided and what are the requirements we are getting, and so we should calculate every one of them so we'll get the better information on ideas of the alignment and performance. Calculating for strategic alignment, value and risk management and resource, we'll check the performance of the ideas, how they are showing results on the IT governments and the organization for profits, and these are the core areas of the IT governments. Well, coming to the workflow of introduction of new system and services, you can check there is a workflow scope assessment. Later, after scope assessment, we have to go to impact analysis, and later we have to go to design capability, and later we have to go to transition service, and later sustainment. Scope is the whether we have any issues with the assessment or not, and what are the impact it will take on the whereas the impact analysis gives you the what are the impact that gives on the assessment and the design work, and later we design the right services that will be helpful in the production and later transition service. After design, we'll go to feasibility transition and then we'll get the result. This is the workflow of the introduction of new system and services. Elements of methodology. In IT governments, business and governments requirements, this is the methodology that every IT process should follow. whereas you can check it has some plan and organize, acquire and implement, deliver and support, monitor and evaluate. These are the four elements that should follow the IT government, so we can get a so they can reach the goals and metrics about the. And we can see that it includes the method of identifying sources of database. We'll get the data, we'll get the sources of database and give a evaluate description on the sources which we are admin and provide the selected sources and describe the process of analysis and introduce to the certain ultimate user, certain ultimately used to certain selected sources to use various methodology here. IT government is very much present in the fields of insurance sectors and many other companies in showing a promising progress, whereas the objectives of the IT government's assessment audit should focus on appraisal of level of alignment and integration of IT strategy with the business strategy, assessment of output of IT component and plus value provided for organization. In this way, the research projects process proposes the following specific audit outputs and material risk associated with the IT governments are based on IT strategy alignment with organizational business strategy, IT government structure with competences and responsibilities associated with to every department, identifying IT costs and decision for IT resources allocation, investment decision, IT developer projects control implemented in order to mitigate IT risk, IT performance assessment and monitoring. These are the proposals that proposals and objectives and material is associated with the IT governments. Security documentation policy. You can see there is a graph or a diagram where the documentation for the IT governments. It is like IT strategy, architecture and documentation is where we can build and blueprint or documentation of existing IT infrastructure. In IT monitoring and support, where we can monitor everything of the IT infrastructure. For third party governments, produce policies, ongoing management, and rest of them will check in the third party governments, where are the cyber security and IT security takes penetration testing and certification, where the what are the risks we are occurring from by using the blueprints or certain methods for IT government. And the last one is business continuity or planning and impact analysis. Here we plan, develop and execute ongoing maintenance and testing, and later we'll go to maintenance. And this is the document policy for audit or examination support to which gives is the better IT government's performance results. These are the better results by using IT governments like information technology governments. Here is the first one, enhanced relationship between organization and IT, whereas the second one is the enterprise risk management of the organization and IT, and the third one is visibility into IT management's ability to achieve its objectives. The fourth one is improves adaptability of IT to changes in organization and environment. And these are the references which I collected the information from the resources.